Fine.
I'm Barbara Adamchuk. I'm the Director of Youth and Connectional Ministries here at Westminster Press, and I'm also one of the producers for this awesome show tonight. I've actually been a producer the first time we did this, I think, I'm trying to remember when it was, 2004, and that was a show I produced, and that wasn't my first show, so I've been at it for a while. I did want to let you know our friend Lisa Kaufman, who has been the producer since the beginning of the series 28 years ago, is actually watching us from at home tonight. Oh. We're live streaming it. So I want you all to say, I'll count to 1, 2, 3 and say hi, Lisa, hi, Mike. Let's say hi, Lisa and Mike. You ready? 1, 2, 3.
Hi, Lisa and Mike.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Well, I know you're going to really love this show tonight. We have, it's kind of funny, I was thinking about it, this time of year is so busy for musicians, I think this is the only way Bob and I get to see each other. He's playing tonight, so that's good. I don't know that I need to tell you anything other than we have doors up here, doors in the back, and a door through the kitchen if there's an emergency, but our pyrotechnics have been toned down this year, so we shouldn't be too wrong. And just simply enjoy the show and the hard work. I wanted to let you know that you'll see the first commercial was written by our directors. I don't think I credited them, so that's a lot of fun. We've had so much fun with this. We're trying to make it like it's the TV production presentation, so we actually have 3 commercial breaks this evening. So, all right. Well, listen, you all have a Merry Christmas and enjoy the show. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
hear what you have to say.
Thank you, Megan. I've always felt like people don't understand me.
Good evening. I am the teacher for the Peanuts Gang. I'd like to introduce those children you may not know so well. Violet. Violet is a girl who enjoys teasing boys, especially Charlie Brown. Pigpen made his debut with Peanuts before going to school. He's happy and messy. For him, it's a fact of life. You should try to read his book reports.
Here's a line I have to say in the Christmas play. See if I can get it right. Hark.
I've always wondered how actors remember all those lines.
Frida has a natural memory, and she knows how to use it. She would like to think that she's an Indian for a little girl. And you may not realize that Shermie was one of the original Peanuts.
There were three wise men. They came from the east. They were looking for Bethlehem. You know how they found it? They found the star.
Who is the star? Do they have hair that's mine? What's the point of having natural curly hair if you can't use it to make people jealous?
Peppermint Patty is one of Charlie's best friends. She's a strong woman who can play sports as well as any boy. Schroeder is a musical prodigy whose spirit animal is Beethoven.
Dear, what's his name again?
Who?
The fat guy with the beard and the red suit.
Why are you writing to our substitute math teacher?
Out of all of my students, Marcy is probably the smartest. She's also the most naive. Peppermint Patty is her best friend. She called her Sir to be polite.
My parents are driving me crazy, Charles. They want me to be perfect. They want me to get straight A's in school. I'm cracking up, Charles. I shouldn't even be here right now. I'm supposed to be reading Ivanhoe.
I don't even know what to say.
Children were to be the active voice.
not adults pretending to be kids. When he was told the play was too religious, he said, if we don't do it, who else can? Charles was a student of the Bible, and he was even teaching adult Bible classes. He went on to say, it is the Christmas story, the birth of our Savior, and the possibilities of peace and goodwill to one another are the real gifts of the season. All that I value in life and living are a part of my play, and these values continue to be what America is still about. Sit back and enjoy your time with the Peanuts crew. Merry Christmas to you and your family, and especially to you, Charlie Brown.
Dang it! My doghouse! What am I gonna do now? I'll start. I'm Jake from State Farm. Like a
Are you in good hands?
I'm sure you know me.
be something wrong with me, Linus. Christmas is coming, and I'm not happy. I don't feel the way I'm supposed to feel. I just don't understand Christmas, I guess. I may be getting presents and sending Christmas cards and decorating trees and all that, but I'm still not happy. I always end up feeling depressed.
Charlie Brown, you're the only person I know who takes a wonderful season like Christmas and turns it into a problem. Maybe Lucy's right. Of all the Charlie Browns in the world, you're the Charlie Brownest.
About this Christmas business, getting depressed and all that. It happens to me every year. here. I never get what I really want. I only get some stupid toys or bicycle or clothes, something stupid like that.
What is it you really want?
Real estate.
Thank you.
right down to it. One of the first things to ensure a good performance is pay strict attention to your direction. I'll keep my direction simple. If I point right, it means focus attention stays right. If I make a slashing motion across my throat, it means cut the scene short. If I make a revolving motion with my hand, it means pick up the tempo. And if I spread my hands apart, it means slow down. It's the spirit of the actors that counts. Am I right? I said it, am I right? Stop the music! All right now, we're gonna do this play and we're gonna do it right. Lucy, get those costumes and the scripts and pass them out. Now, the script girl will be passing out the cards.
Frida?
Yes?
You're the innkeeper's wife.
The innkeeper's wives have naturally curly hair.
Pigpen? You're the innkeeper.
In spite of my outward appearance, I shall try to let a neat inn.
Charmy? You're a shepherd.
Every Christmas is the same. I always need a shepherd.
Snoopy, you'll have to play all the animals in play. Can you be a sheep?
Bah.
How about a cow?
Moo.
How about a penguin? Yes, she's even good at being a penguin.
Squawk, squawk!
No. Listen, all of you. You've got to take direction. You've got to have discipline. You've got to have respect for your director. I love you.
I've been given by a dog. I have dog germs. Get some hot water. Get some disinfectant. Get some iodine.
All right, script girl. Continue with the scripts.
Linus. Get rid of that stupid blanket. And here, memorize these lines.
I can't memorize these lines. This is ridiculous.
Memorize it and be ready when your cue comes.
I can't memorize some lines just so quickly. Why should I even go through such agony? Give me one good reason why I should memorize these lines.
I'll give you 5 good reasons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Those are good reasons. Christmas is not only being too commercial, it's getting too dangerous.
And get rid of that stupid blanket. What's a Christmas shepherd gonna look like with a stupid blanket like that?
Well, this is one Christmas shepherd who's gonna keep his trusty blanket with him. See, you wouldn't hit an innocent shepherd, would you?
All right, Mr. Director, the cast is set. Take over.
Shutter, set the mood for the first scene.
Good grief.
All right. the top again. Places, action.
What do you want?
The proper move. We need a Christmas tree.
Hey, perhaps a tree. A great big shiny aluminum Christmas tree. That's it, Charlie Brown. You get the tree. I'll handle this crowd.
I'll take liners with me. The rest of you practice your line.
Get the biggest aluminum tree you can find and maybe paint it pink.
Yeah, it's something red for a change, Charlie Brown.
Thank you.
talked about how great Beethoven was.
Beethoven wasn't so great.
What do you mean Beethoven wasn't so great?
Beethoven's never had his picture on a bubblegum card, has he? Have you ever seen Beethoven's picture on a bubblegum card? How can you say someone's famous if they've never had their picture on a bubblegum card?
Good. Great.
Say, by the way, could you play
Jingle Bells?
No. I mean Jingle Bells. You know, deck them halls and all that stuff.
Shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And then there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men. That's what Christmas is all about, Charlie Brown.
For behold, I bring you tidings of great joy which will be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord, and this shall be a sign unto you.
Linus is right. I won't let all this commercialism get to me. I'll take this tree home and decorate it, and I'll show them it really will work on our Christmas play.
Thank you.
I'm not one to recite lines, but I would like to thank a very special person watching at home tonight. Her name's Lisa Kaufman. She's integral to the Westminster community and the success of Westminster Plays.
We you guys-